In this video, we're going to talk about the peripheral chemoreceptors, the cells responsible for sensing blood chemistry and helping maintain control of ventilation and tissue homeostasis. The primary cells responsible for this chemoreception are known as the glomus cells. And these glomus cells are essentially modified neurons that release neurotransmitter in response to particular stimuli. They're actually found in two main locations. They're found in the carotid artery in the neck, and they're found in the aortic arch. And those two locations are adaptive. The aorta, of course, carries blood flow to our entire systemic circuit, whereas the carotid artery carries blood flow to our head, including the brain. And so this is sensing the blood chemistry going out to our bodies with backup sensing of blood going specifically to the brain tissue. Now, what these glomus cells are sensitive to is oxygen levels, carbon dioxide levels, and free proton levels, or pH. The changes that stimulate the glomus cells would include hypoxemia, that's low oxygenation of the blood, hypercapnia, that's an increase in CO2 levels in the blood, and then finally acidosis, or an increase in free proton levels in the blood. Now note that the hypercapnia is actually tied to the acidosis due to a shifting of the carbonic acid equation with an introduction of increased CO2 that causes an increase in free proton levels, a fall in pH. Hypoxemia is probably the strongest of these stimuli for the glomus cells as compared to the central chemoreceptors in the brain that are more sensitive to hypercapnia, CO2 levels. Now, in response to these changes, we're going to get an increase in neurotransmitter release, an increase in action potential generation along these sensory neurons, and those sensory neurons are innervating our medullary control centers, largely the DRG, the dorsal respiratory group, and the VRG, the ventral respiratory group, that directly innervate our respiratory muscles and help change the rate and depth of ventilation. Now, when do these changes occur? Well, all three of these changes occur in response to an increase in metabolism, right? Such as might occur during exercise, right? We use more oxygen during exercise, we produce more CO2, the CO2 production would cause an increase in free protons and in acidosis. And so we need to maintain homeostasis when our metabolic rate rises. And so as we can see at the bottom here, if our PO2 is normal, if we're at rest, right, our PO2 of our bloodstream is normal, and our output of these sensory neurons, right, in blue here, shown on the red line, is very low, right? At resting PO2 levels, we don't need a lot of stimulatory output to our respiratory control centers. But you can see as our blood PO2 falls, what's going to happen is the output along those sensory neurons is going to increase, right? Our glomus cells are going to release more neurotransmitter, action potential frequency will rise, and we're going to more strongly stimulate our respiratory control centers. When we get down here in the danger zone, right, lower PO2 in that arterial blood, look what happens, right? All of a sudden, we're going to enter this exponential portion of the curve and get this enormous increase in the output to those respiratory control centers. We'll be hyperventilating dramatically with increased rate and depth of ventilation to help restore homeostasis following these particular changes over here, which were stimulatory to those glomus cells.